Hello. Happy Tuesday. Here I am in the volcano. You've seen me reach this point a couple times now. If I go through here, this is the desert. And if I go this way, hey, we're back in the town of Summers. Awesome. Let's see what Summers has to offer. Okay. This is the hotel. So this is way back on level 3. If I wanted to, I could use the shortcut and go back to Tucson and go to the sanctuary and get rid of this haunting. But let's explore Summers a little bit more first. There might be a hospital or something here. I forget what I've already explored, so apologies. Another telephone. Oh, ATM. How I wish you were a real ATM. Will these things run from me? They will. Not that frog, though. That frog is feeling froggy. Okay, I remember this. There's nothing important there. Run away from the ghost! Run away from the ghost! I made it. I need a pizza here. Still don't have a pizza. Sorry, friend. I would give you a pizza if I had a pizza. Well, I would eat a pizza if I had a pizza. I would give you a pizza if I had two pizzas. But alas, I don't even have one. This can't cure a haunting, right? No. I didn't think so. I wanted to double check. Are you a real hint man? I don't think you are. No. You look thrilled. The zombie is thrilled to be here. I think you mean return to the sand of the beach. There's Monty's cousin. Chillin', getting a tan. Hi, frog. Hi, bug. So, since my last recording session, my spouse heard me talking about my A button sticking on my controller, and while I was at work one day, she thoroughly cleaned it. She cleaned both my controllers, because she wasn't sure at the time which one I was talking about. And it worked. My A button isn't sticking anymore. I didn't think I would be able to clean it thoroughly enough without taking it apart. And I don't have the tool that I need to take it apart. But, Izzy, she used this tool. And she told me what it's called and what its original purpose was, but of course I forget. But it's like a pair of tweezers with extremely sharp points, like needle sharp points. And she took that and she took some alcohol wipes and she gave my controller just a thorough cleaning. And this controller, you know, I'm going to call it as good as new. Like, it looks immaculate, and so far the A button seems to be doing its job. So, thank you, Izzy. Well, this is another shortcut point. Let's see where this goes. If you give this person the tiny ruby, they step aside and let you through the door. Or disappear. Either way. Okay, this is back at the What is Love level. Which I have still not properly made it to. At some point, she poked herself with the extremely sharp tweezers, which is very easy to do. It's a very fiddly thing to use, so... blood has been shed for this playthrough. So, everyone, be sure to thank Izzy for making this more enjoyable. Treasure. I threw away the treasure. Oh, right. Just like me? The one holding the controller? Okay. Well, I have to be careful to spell my name correctly here. I don't want to make any errors. You're welcome. Yep, that's me. The one and only. Aww. Tony's a big fan of Mario. I have a hamburger. I have two of them. Where'd you go? Yeah, this is that other shortcut in Tucson that I didn't go back there because... Oh. Do I have the King Banana? I do. Okay, so this isn't the two hamburger spot. That's another monkey who wants a hamburger. Okay, where does this go? Oh. Wait. How do both of these shortcuts go to the same... Whatever. Spooky dungeon floor with very pretty music. Is that real? Oh my god, that is so helpful. Thank you. Who do I want to have the flame pendant? So here's the thing about question mark. They can equip anything, but if I were to equip this flame pendant, their defense would drop from 11 to 0. But they would get the benefit of the flame pendant, which is... protects you from fire attacks. Doesn't Ness have something that gives some protection? No. So I think dropping from 11 defense to 0 for question mark wouldn't be that big a deal. Like, 11 defense is not that much of a buffer. But the pendant itself also provides a little bit of defense to the other players. the other characters. Yeah, 52 to 65. Okay. I will give question mark a pendant at some point. Hopefully a better one than a flame. Oh, well, I have no idea how much this will hurt. So, I'm going to pull out all the stops here. Okay. I pushed my luck long enough. As pretty as this music is, we'll listen to it some more once I get to that level properly. Yeah, it's so weird that both of those shortcuts go to the same place. I don't know how that happens. Do I have a skip sandwich? I do. Sorry, I need to cough. One moment. Alright, apologies. I coughed and I got a drink. I didn't figure that was worth stopping the recording for. What do you want? Oh, right. I threw away my picnic lunch. I forgot that's a key item. Well, maybe I'll get another one. Kitty lives there. Too late, buddy. Too late. That's how I feel. I'm afraid of the Kraken. Can I walk? Okay. Okay, right, that's just that. Oh. I see. It's not the same exit. It's just a similar looking building. I see. Still weird. It's still weird for two shortcuts to lead to the same floor of the dungeon. Like, I thought they were all supposed to be... Oh, thank you, Magnet Hill. This is another sanctuary. And that guy up there is being a creeper. Treasure. Mr. Baseball Bat. It's definitely worse than the Big League Bat, right? Yeah, it's much worse. What's your deal, video game? Right, that's a statue. You're the one who keeps crashing my game. I don't like you. That leads to the What is Love dungeon. And that's the way back, if I want to go that way. Okay, that's the way back here. Where does this door go? I know I've asked that question like 10 times now. Right, the restaurant. Okay. I was really hoping one of these would lead to like a department store or something. Pardon me. Pizza. Yeah, I totally forgot one of the monkeys asked for a picnic lunch, otherwise I would have held on to it. Okay, well, other than Magnet Hill, Summers was kind of a bust. Maybe I should use my exit mouse at Magnet Hill. Huge disparity in like the power levels of enemies here. Like, I fought something with over 500 hit points, and I fought something with 50 hit points. I'm not going south because I'm pretty sure there's nothing valuable there. Like, it's just a bunch of NPCs milling around and a bunch of enemies. Alright, I won't actually activate it because I don't need to. But I'll mark this location. I would mark this location so I don't have to leave and go back into the sanctuary, but it would spawn me like way over to the left or something. So it's easier to do it this way. Hi, friend. I can insta-kill one of these things. Alright. Well, I am glad, at least, that I determined there's nothing of value in that part of the desert. Because I never have to go back out there again. Hi, Croco friend. Well, my two leads for things to explore have both been kind of a bust. Bye, Ant. Maybe I should continue going this way in search of an ATM after fighting the zombie dog. Heal. Sit. Good dog. Thank you. That's empty. The spray doesn't change, so I have to double check. Okay, I remember this. I remember this. That's just a big old dead end. Mercifully free of monsters. Not having random encounters makes this a more pleasant experience than a lot of randomizers. I mean, it still has encounters that you can't really avoid. But trying to find your way around is a lot more frustrating when you get attacked every couple of steps. Like, at least in this, I occasionally get a reprieve from combat. Right, that is in fact a dead end. I should be doing combat because I do need experience points and new spells and stuff. But at this point, what I need more, I think, is better equipment. Like, that's the real bottleneck in this run so far. Once I get better defensive items, I should be pretty prepared for level 5. Ow. But I think Monty survived that hit with 1 hit points because of her guts. Oh, 9 hit points. Okay. So it was very close to a mortal blow. And sometimes characters with high guts can survive a mortal blow with 1 hit point. I mean, I'm level 30. That's kind of, you know, in pace, because in vanilla Earthbound, I usually finish the game at about level 60, and I am at about the halfway mark. In theory. I just need better stuff. I'd really like to come back to you with money. I want that, and I want those. I have to backtrack even further. Which, if that has to be the way it is, so be it. You freeze one ant. You attack Chompy's ghost. You freeze the other ant. Good job. Miss! How preposterous. Oop, sorry. Bumped my mic stand there. Yay! I'm winning! Alright, that's the desert. Do not want. that Summers do not want. Which means that way must lead back to level 3. Alright, same plan. Monty, you freeze an ant. Question mark, you freeze an ant. Everyone else gang up on Chompy's ghost. Good job. An efficient round of combat there. Except for not finishing off that ant, but that's okay. I need to heal Ness. I mean, I don't need to, but I like to keep their health topped up at over 100. Or top off their health once they fall below 100. That leads me back there. Right, the way back was through Summers. I need to go back through Summers. Crud. I forget which building it was. It's one of these buildings. The hospital? No, that takes me further down. I think it was like one of these stucco buildings over to the right. Is this stucco? Alright, well that's where my exit mouse leads. My sense of direction in video games is better than it used to be, but it's still not great. Alright, the ATM takes me to the restaurant. I do remember that. These flies aren't going to let me through. I'm sorry, the unsullied weevils. Well, we are well back into trash mob territory, so at least I don't have to think too much about these battles. And fighting my way back here, once I get an ATM, won't be too dangerous. Once I get an ATM, being the optimistic way of phrasing that. Alright, I got a surprise attack. I'm going to run. Because at this point, I would really just like to advance. Although, I might be advancing to a dead end right now. I'm conflicted as to whether I want to do some of this stuff off camera. Because, yeah, that's a dead end. In some ways, the getting lost is part of the challenge of a randomizer. And that's one of the reasons to watch. At least that's one of the reasons I watch people play randomizers. Is to see them overcome, you know, the odds to get a sense of where they're going and to solve the puzzle, so to speak. But I know some people are super frustrated by watching that kind of stuff. Oh, the group that I targeted was gone, so the spell didn't do anything. Hey! That is not very nice. My Ness. What did Ness ever do to you besides hit you with a baseball bat? Exactly. Nothing. But, you know, I just tell myself that I can't please everyone. Some people like watching people overcome a challenge, find their way, solve the puzzle, and some people don't. And to the people who don't, you know, go do something that gives you pleasure instead. That's all I can really say. Thunder. Nice. Two hits. Alright, this should take out all three of those blobbies. That's a pretty big range of damage on Psylaser. Like, one of them got hit for 99 and one of them got hit for, like, 230-something. That's kind of weird. Defend. Like, I keep saying I'll do stuff off-camera, but, like, if it were me, and I'm watching a randomizer, I would want to see that stuff. That's part of the story. It's part of the journey. I don't know. My thing is making the kind of videos that I would want to watch. Which I do. They're not for everyone. And that's okay. Not everything has to be for everyone. So sick of these ants. I need to double check my settings on the randomizer, because I thought the enemies were I'm back here. Okay. This isn't going to freeze on me, is it? Thank God. I haven't saved in a while. Okay, well, tune in tomorrow for more of me getting lost and backtracking and trying to find things. Or don't. Goodbye.